All right, let's do this. Hello, Sophie here. So today, we are in for quite the adventure. Today, I invite you to follow along with me as we create an animated 3D horse skeleton together in grease pencil. So the link at the top of the description box will take you to a Gumroad page where you can download for free this horse skeleton mesh that I sculpted and animated. I've decided to just offer my base mesh for free for all of you so that we could just dive right into creating something really cool with grease pencil. So for this piece, I will be using as my reference my very well-loved copy of Animal Anatomy for Artists. And so of course I can't share the actual images of this book because copyrights. And so the free download also includes my own horse skeleton reference sheet that I made. So we'll start by opening up the free file we downloaded. So we get this scary looking pop-up. That's just because I used the Rigify add-on for the horse skeleton. So you can just click allow. So we can see that this blend file contains the horse skeleton meshes in this collection. We have our rig here, and the camera is in this collection here. The rig was generated using the Rigify add-on that comes with Blender. If you're curious, you can access it by going into Edit, into Preferences, and search for Rigify. And that's the add-on right there, comes with Blender. So the mesh was sculpted using a combination of subdivided cylinders, spheres, and grids, like for the shoulder blade and pelvis. I've already parented it to the rig. If we scrub along the timeline, we can see that it's already set up with a running animation. And then all I did was I added more windows so I could have more views of my scene. This one here is the perfect little view for my little webcam face feed. So you can see it's just set to the front view, which I get by hovering over that window and hitting numpad 1. And then this window is set to the side view, which I get by hitting numpad 3. And then the only other change I made to Blender's default 2D animation document is I set it up so that when I press tab, I get this pie menu. And then I can switch modes just by hitting tab and dragging. I just quickly set that up by going into Edit and then Preferences. And then in Key Map, I select this box that says tab for pie menu. So I'll just go back to frame 1, which has all the meshes at their default standing position. I can hide the rig. And we'll hide the camera again. So the first thing I do before getting started drawing on 3D meshes with grease pencil is that I like to select my mesh, go into the modifiers properties, this blue wrench icon, and we want to give it a solidify modifier. This is so that we can draw on the surface of the mesh with consistent offset. All we want to do is set the offset to 1 and set the thickness to about 0.02. You also want to make sure to apply all transforms when you do this. So you can do that just by selecting the mesh, hitting Ctrl A, and select Apply All Transforms. Now I've grouped the limbs together, but I've kept the different sections along the center of the body separate, which will just help us out later down the line. And so to very easily share our solidify modifier, we can do that up here in the scene collection. So we can open up the drop-down menu of the object we gave the modifier to. We can open up the modifiers drop-down, and then we can just drag the blue solidify modifier to all the other meshes. All right, so in the end, 0.02 thickness was way too huge, so I brought them all down to 0.01. So with my cursor hovering over the scene collection, I'll close that. I can right-click and select New Collection. And I'll name this grease pencil. Now we can press Shift A and we'll add a new grease pencil stroke object. As you can see, because our 3D cursor is at the world origin, so is the origin of this new grease pencil object. And that's perfect, that's what we want. So then we can just tab, go into edit mode, hit A to select this stroke, and then we'll delete it. Then we can tab to go into draw mode. And so what we want to do to draw on 3D surfaces is up here, set the stroke placement to surface and set the offset to 0. And for this tutorial, we'll just use the default grease pencil brush. And for the sake of keeping this tutorial to the point and short, we'll just make it a black and white piece. And so we'll draw in material mode, by making sure this box up here is selected, and we'll draw using the black stroke material. So, since we won't be changing brushes or colors at all, we can hit N to hide that window. And now we can start drawing. I'll start with the shoulder blades. And so I'll go back into object mode, select the spine, and hit H to hide it for now. And then I can select my grease pencil stroke object in the scene collection and get back to draw mode. So I'll just be sharing some guidelines because there's really a lot of ways to get creative with this, and I encourage you to put your own personal spin on it. So from what I've seen, grease pencil isn't really made for 3D animation like we're gonna be doing it today. And so what I'm showing you is a bit of a workaround. And so for it to work, each bone needs to be drawn in its own grease pencil object. Not a huge deal. So the easiest way to do this would be, now that I'm finished the shoulder blade, I can just go into object mode, hit Shift D to duplicate it, right click to snap it back in place. So now with the duplicate selected, I can go into edit mode, once again, hit A to select everything and delete. And now we can start right away on the humerus. All of our settings are exactly how we want them, so that'll save us some time for going between the different grease pencil objects. So I'm not doing this quite so much now just because I've drawn on meshes so many times and I know what to expect. But if you'd like to see how your grease pencil strokes are gonna look in your final piece, the best way to do that is by going into render view and seeing how they look. And then all you'd wanna do is, for now, turn off the solidify modifier. So notice that I'm just drawing the bones on one side. And so to mirror them, we just want to select our grease pencil object, go into the modifier section, and we'll add a mirror modifier. And then, like before, we can share it in the scene collection by opening the drop-down menus and just dragging it into our other stroke object. And just like that, we already have four bones down. So exactly how you choose to draw the line art is a very stylistic choice. I try to follow the flow of the 3D object I'm drawing on top of. You also have to think that you want the line art to make sense when viewed from any angle. So for the long bones, I find that what best sells this effect is to draw 3 to 4 lines outlining the bone. And I also like to give them some curves so that occasionally you can see multiple of these outline lines in one view. Have fun with this. Get creative, try stuff out. So when I want to delete a line, I'm personally not a fan of grease pencil's eraser tool. So what I like to do instead is to just go into edit mode. And then my favorite is the lasso select tool. And then with the select mode being on the vertices, I can select the vertices of an area that's giving me a bit of trouble. And then I hit delete. And then I can select either the points or the stroke as a whole. And so other than just, you know, hitting Control Z right after I've made the line, this is how I handle wanting to erase and redraw a certain line. So I'm sticking mostly to the outlines, but feel free to add as much detail here as you want. You can play around with your line thickness by hitting F, and you can hit Shift F to play around with the opacity of your brush. So I've just provided the base here today, and you can still get something totally unique, and I encourage you to experiment and see what you can create in your style with different line thicknesses, different effects. So something to watch out for when drawing on 3D surfaces is that if your grease pencil stroke goes past the mesh and it hits another object, you can get something pretty unexpected. We're seeing double because of the mirror modifier. And so this hasn't really been a big deal to my workflow. They really stand out when they happen, so they're pretty easy to deal with. When they do happen, I go into edit mode, and then with the vertices select mode, I lasso select the vertices and then I just delete the points. And otherwise, while I'm drawing, I just try to rotate around the object while keeping in mind that I don't want it to pass that object and intersect with a mesh behind it. And then you can always temporarily hide other objects in object mode by selecting them and hitting H. And then to unhide them, you can hit Alt H. So now that we have the front leg down, would probably be helpful to name them. So because the scene collection is ordered based on alphabetical, I like to name my bones with numbers and letters so I can group them together and keep them in order. So starting at the top, the scapula, I like to name this F0 for foreleg, F for foreleg, and 0 for the first bone. Or technically, you know, it's the shoulder blade, it's like the pre-first arm bone. So then I just work my way down the leg, F0, F1, F2, F3, F4. So you can very easily rename something by selecting the object and hitting F2. And so now I'll just go ahead and name all of them as I described. So definitely one of the reasons I picked horses is because they just have one toe. And so we can treat the whole foot as just another one of these cylindrical bones, except that you can see I marked with grease pencil the different bones and also the hoof. So now, once again, this is something that I would do more continually as I work, but to just see how the strokes are looking, let's go into render view and then hide the solidify modifier on our mesh. I think she's looking cute. So we'll put the solidify modifier back and go into solid view again. So now with all of that in mind, I'll head on and do the back leg and I'll name them R0 to R4 for the rear leg. So here's how the limbs are looking back in render view with the solidify modifier turned off. So now we can move on to the center skeleton. Or, if you're feeling fancy, now that we've finished the appendicular skeleton, we can move on to the axial skeleton. So we'll go back into solid view, and then in object mode, we can hit Alt H to unhide everything. And then we can select our spine, hit Control I to select everything else, and then we'll hit H to hide everything other than the spine. Now we'll duplicate one of our grease pencil stroke objects, rename it spine, go into edit mode, delete everything, and then we can start drawing the spine. So I'm not gonna lie, I've kind of done most of the work here for you. You're welcome. Because the mesh sticks up and emulates the spines of the spine, yes, the spines of the spine, you can just get a good view and then draw a straight line over top the mesh, and then the magic of grease pencil will stick to the mesh and make these shapes for you. So I think that's very cool. So with this in mind, I do like before, I outline the spine and then I also add those details, you know, between the individual spines. So it seems like for this test run I'm doing, the spine isn't like perfectly mirrored. So I'm getting these kinds of things, but I'll fix that for the version that you are going to get. No worries. All right, we are getting there. Now we can go back into object mode. And again, we'll hit Alt H to unhide everything. Go away, rig. I've set it up so it's possible for the horse to open its mouth. I wanted to keep that in for anyone who wanted the option to add in that animation, or if you're feeling comfortable enough to animate the rig yourself. So if you are someone who'd want to do that, you just want to make sure to make two separate grease pencil stroke objects for the skull, one for the jaw and one for the top of the skull. But since I'm keeping it simple for this tutorial, and since my running animation doesn't involve any mouth movement, I'll just make the choice to draw the skull in one grease pencil object and I won't animate the jaw at all. Another thing that makes horses an easy skeleton for beginners is that their skull doesn't have any big parts sticking out. If you have a look at carnivore skulls, so the skulls of cats or dogs, for example, you'll see that they have these huge zygomatic arches, which is definitely possible to sculpt and draw on top of, and I have for some of my skeletons. But for a beginner tutorial, I'm so glad that we can just stick to a simple, almost flat skull. So for the skull, I'm just keeping it simple, again, following the form. I also shaded in the eye sockets, and I drew in the teeth and outlined the nose, as you can see. So last but not least, we have the ribcage, except the ribcage is so deceptively tricky and complex that it's actually going to get its whole own segment. So the next video will be just about that, darn ribcage. So thank you so much for being here and for checking out my first official big tutorial. If you follow this, I would absolutely love to see what you make. You can tag me on Instagram or at Twitter. I'm at Sophie Jantek everywhere. And that's it for today. I will see you very, very, very soon. Bye.